Welcome to NewsClick. Lok Sabha elections have been announced and we are right now in Kashmir to talk about the recent developments ahead of general elections 2019. Currently, the state of Jammu and Kashmir is under president's rule. Recently, ECI, Election Commission of India, announced that there will be no simultaneous assembly polls. The decision has disappointed regional political parties who see this as an attempt to disenfranchise people of the state, especially Kashmir. To talk more on this and to talk about the political situation in Kashmir, we are joined by political representatives from different political parties. Let me welcome Tanveer Sadiq, advisor to Omar Abdullah, Suhail Bukhari, PDP spokesperson and media advisor to Mehbooba Mufti, Ghulam Nabi Malik, State Secretary CPIM. Thanks for joining us. Let me begin with you, Suhail Bukhari. Your party was in alliance, PDP was in alliance with BJP. 5 years of Modi rule is coming to an end. How would you describe centre's policy towards Kashmir and how has it affected the state in general?
Well, you know, Narendra Modi coming to power in the centre had happened after a long, long time, given the kind of mandate that he came with and the strength that he had come with. It was a golden opportunity when it comes to Kashmir because in order to resolve the issue of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, there has to be a very strong and bold decision making that has to be done. And we were of the opinion that probably this was unprecedented and he had the right ingredients to make it to the statesmanship of taking initiatives that would go a long way in ensuring that the issue of Jammu and Kashmir is resolved through dialogue, which is external as well as internal, engaging the state of Pakistan and also engaging the leadership across the board, whether the mainstream or for that matter separatist leadership as well, to try and find consensus on issues that would pave way for the overall resolution. But we now have come to a position where, it's for anyone and everyone to see that Narendra Modi has squandered that opportunity.
So you think that Modi government has been a failure for the state?
When it comes to Jammu and Kashmir state, yes, definitely a failure at the end of the day, because the initiatives that he could have taken, that the government could have taken, they did not follow through.
Hold on to that, Suhail. I would like to move to Tanveer Sadiq. As Suhail said that Modi government has been a failure for the state of Jammu and Kashmir, do you see any credibility left for the regional political parties as they are going to contest elections?
Well, when we say credibility, of course the regional parties have credibility. The fact that my friend in the PDP thinks that Modi or BJP haven't been sincere to Kashmir only after they were thrown out of the government. I wish they had realized this long before when they formed the government and when National Conference and the Congress supported them unconditionally.
But sorry, Tanveer, you're digressing from the question that I asked. I'm asking that, is there any credibility left of the regional political parties? Because we have ground reports by NewsClick, local media and international media that suggest that locals in Kashmir are indifferent to elections. And they feel that by and large, it's not going to change the situation on the ground. That is APSPA, that is the day-to-day killings. What does that mean?
Okay, let me not go not very far in the past, but I'll just go in 2014. 2014 saw one of the best elections of Jammu and Kashmir when people came out to vote. Probably they didn't vote for us, but they came out and voted. So if things were very good then, of course there has been something wrong ever since 2014 that people have really got dissatisfied from the electoral process. Now, there were two, three things, and then I'll come to the main point. Two, three things is that the reapproachment, the reaching out to the people stopped, the dialogue process stopped, the interlocutors, any of those reports that were made, people were not taken into consideration. So, of course, people were upset. But if you ask me today what people want, the first and foremost thing that people want is an elected government to come into being. Now, who they vote is... let's leave it to the people who they vote. But they want an elected government because they have seen what governor rule can do to them. Right now, what the governor or the government of India should do is to hold elections. Let people decide who they want to vote for.
Talking about change, as you said, let me move to Ghulam Nabi Malik. Shah Faisal launched his party yesterday. He was talking about change. He was talking about ab hawa badlegi. You being from CPIM, do you think that in a highly polarized nationalistic and socio-religious space, what kind of room is left for the left politics now?
I think you will allow me to speak in Urdu. yeah, that will be proper for me. Jahan tak left ka taluq hai, in the sense of electoral right, hamara ye sawal hai democratic issues aur ye nationalities issues ke sath sath jo basic mamlaat hain aam logon ke, jaise sare mulk mein hum we are the people jo ne kisanon ke issues uthaye, matlab ladies aur unke issues uthaye, working class issues uthaye, that are very much there, wo to yahan bhi hai. और अभी ना कल ना हमारा काजीगुड़ में था वर्कर्स कन्वेंशन था और बड़ा अच्छा प्रोग्राम रहा वहाँ पर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू ऑर्गेनाइज सच प्रोग्राम्स एवरीवेयर इन द स्टेट.
और हमें आपको लगता है कि लेफ्ट के लिए कुछ जगह बची हुई है?
जरूर है. देखिए हमारी आज भी आप देखिए कश्मीर की तरफ, सिर्फ कश्मीर में ही आपको सारे मुल्क में लाल चौक मिलेगा, लाल चौक, दैट इज रेड स्क्वायर, मास्को एंड देन हियर. और हमारा नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस का नया कश्मीर, दैट इज़ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ ताजिकिस्तान, दैट इज़ वेरी मच हेयर ऑपरेटिव. ये मतलब इनकी भी हिस्ट्री वही रही है, नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस की हिस्ट्री वही रही है, वो कम्युनिस्ट ने मिलजुल कर ये सारा किया और दैट हिस्ट्री इज़ विद अस.
कैन आई जस्ट एड देयर, यू नो, बिकॉज यू टॉक्ड अबाउट द रीजनल पोलिटिकल पार्टीज, यू नो, देयर हैज़ बीन अ कंसर्टेड एफर्ट बाई गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया और डेली टाइम एंड अगेन टू सम हाउ बी लिटल और you know push the mainstream political parties to the wall, and that is the worst thing any government in Delhi could do, because at the end of the day the mainstream are the people who have taken the flag of the country, who have lost, whether it is PDP, National Conference, CPM or any political party, we have lost our activists, our cadre at the hands of militants and all. In spite of that, if we were the one who come in the forefront for the people, and if government of India's effort is to push us to the walls, who do they ask to? Because we never said that we believe in terrorism, we never said that we believe in gun culture, we said we believe in a dialogue process, we believe in the constitution of the country. But in spite of that, this effort in the last 4 years time and again to belittle us, to push us to the wall, has been the worst. We have been the worst sufferers.
And I would want to add one very important point to this. Look at what happened when there was a possibility of a government coming to form wherein PDP, National Conference and Congress could have come together. Just recently, what did happen? The governor, of course, under strict instructions from the government of India, dissolved the state assembly. And look at the kind of narrative that was being pushed. On primetime television, nobody was questioning the daylight heist that was carried by the governor at that point in time. All that was being talked about, well, it was done because, you know, it would have meant anti-nationals coming together to form the government. Now, if the mainstream political parties who abide by the constitution go through electoral process, if they are anti-nationals, they are anti, you know, pro-Pakistan, they are not for the constitution, what's left of you?
Modi sahab ne act kiya, jo hum पहले भी जो हम समझ रहे थे और जो साबित भी हुआ, वो सिर्फ उसने एक्ट जम्मू कश्मीर के सिलसिले में एज प्राइम मिनिस्टर नहीं किया, उसने एक्ट किया बीजेपी एंड आरएसएस, और उनका एजेंडा है, हमारी अंडरस्टैंडिंग यह है कि उनका एजेंडा शुरू हुआ यहाँ 1951 में जब श्याम प्रसाद मुखर्जी की सरबराही में अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी, एल के आडवाणी और दीनदयाल उपाध्याय, मतलब इन तीन लोगों को लेकर कश्मीर के खिलाफ वहाँ ना महाज खोला, और वही एजेंडा आज तक चल रहा है उनका, उसी एजेंडे को लेकर उन्होंने सरकार वहाँ पर हासिल कर ली. हाउ इट इज़ पॉसिबल कि वो इसको ना लॉस कर लेंगे? दे विल नेवर अलो कश्मीरीज टू गेट देयर जेन्युइन राइट्स. और नहीं तो जो कुछ यहाँ कुछ लोग यहाँ चाहते भी क्या, हम तो सभी तो मिलजुल कर कहते हैं कि 370 को, मतलब उसके जो ना बेसिक्स हैं उसको इम्प्लीमेंट कर लीजिए, और इंटरनेशनल कहा जाता है उसे पाकिस्तानी कहा जाता है, यही तो मुल्क में भी बात हो रही है.
होल्ड ऑन टू दैट गुलाम नबी, आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क सुहेल बुखारी, यू सेड पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज, महबूबा वाज रिसेंटली कॉल्ड प्रो पाकिस्तानी, बीइंग कॉल्ड एंटी नेशनल्स, एंड व्हेन दे डिस्क्राइब कश्मीर इन द अदर स्टेट्स ऑफ इंडिया, कश्मीरीज आर सीन एज रेडिकलाइज्ड यूथ. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ रेडिकलाइजेशन इज गोइंग ऑन इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर?
वेल, the only radicalization vis-a-vis Jammu and Kashmir and the youngsters of Kashmiris is happening in the narrative factories of RSS and of course the primetime television debates. On ground, what is happening is not radicalization but alienation, and something that anybody who has even a basic understanding of human psyche would agree to. Now, there's an attack which happens in Pulwama, and you hold almost every Kashmiri responsible for that attack. Without even terming them Pakistanis, you behave and act against them as they were, as if they were the real perpetrators.
And the Prime Minister keeps silent the Supreme Court intervenes.
That's precisely what I'm saying. Leave aside the contours of Jammu and Kashmir state. You saw what happened in Jammu. Kashmiris were victimized. There was arson.
As you're talking about Jammu, let me ask Tanveer Sadiq. While everyone talks about, in India, everyone talks about radicalization in Kashmir, they often miss the point that that there is another kind of radicalization that has become dominant in last 5 years, that is Hindutva radicalization, which was very evident recently when the Jammu was under curfew. And what do you want to say about the Hindutva radicalization, the liberal voices in Jammu which are disappearing?
See, there are two things. One, when you're talking about radicalization in the valley or the state and the radicalization in the rest of the country. Now, rest of the country, I'll start with that. Let's say there was an agenda of Hindutva, like this is a Hindutva agenda where you want to really put one community against the other, because somehow or the other they would win votes out of it. And this is what precisely the last four and five years, this has been, whether it was Babri Masjid, whether it was the lynching of Ikhlaq, whether all these episodes or killing of Gauri Lankesh. Across the country, these radicalized people were getting support from registered, you know, political parties. So they knew that nobody would touch them, and they just had a free hand. Now, over the years, the BJP, I believe, and I mean, this is what I hear or read, is that BJP itself wanted whatever trouble is in Kashmir helps them electorally in the rest of the country. You kill, you maim, you pellet the citizens or the members of this region, it automatically helps BJP to sell that in the rest of the country. I'll just finish this point. Now imagine a boy being tied up to a jeep. A person who goes out and votes, instead of ensuring that the officer who did that would have been behind the bars, the rest of the country rose up and said and awarded that person. Now tell me, where in the world would this happen?
You digressed a little. I was asking you that the radicalization, or to say that close affinity of people in Jammu to BJP and right-wing voices, do you think that is going to affect Kashmir? Because we saw that affected Kashmir recently, in the aftermath of Pulwama attack. I want you to talk about that.
I don't want to start a two-two match, but I'm telling you time and again, ever since 2014, and this is precisely, I'm repeating, I didn't want to say this, but ever since PDP and BJP government came into being, the division has been at the worst end. I mean, people started talking, let's bring Jammu and Kashmir together, but it has boomeranged, it has gone up opposite to what everybody thought. I mean, the tallest leader of my friend's political party, Mufti Mohammad Saeed, when he formed the government with the BJP, he said, I want to bring Jammu and Kashmir together so that, you know, they come closer together. But that has not been the case. It has gone even worse than what it was earlier. The fact that the Hindutva voices in Jammu, for the first time in 70 years, took out a rally with weapons and swords in their hands in Doda and Jammu itself meant that they had the backing of BJP. And unfortunately,
and
the
that
government
means
that...
dangerous situation.
Dangerous situation. And unfortunately, the chief minister was from the PDP then. I wish it was stopped then. Because if you had stopped it then...
So Suhail Bukhari wants to make a point. Yeah, please.
I see, basically, what the patron of PDP, Mufti Mohammad Saeed, said, or for that matter did essentially, while they formed the coalition with BJP, was essentially based on this root cause, that there are fault lines between these two divisions that ought to be ensured that they do not, you know, erupt in a volcanic situation. And essentially, till the government was there, it was ensured that such a thing does not happen. Because I would want to quote an example. Before Pulwama attack, do you even realize that there was an attack on the Amarnath Yatra? The pilgrims who had come from Gujarat, they were attacked. But did we see that kind of backlash in Jammu, or for that matter elsewhere in the country? No. The reason was that the BJP as a political party remained engaged in the state through that alliance in the state.
Let me go to Ghulam Nabi Malik. left politics, the immediate enemy of left politics has always been RSS. Right-wing voices gaining ground in Jammu. What do you think of that?
ये तो आज की बात वैसे है नहीं, मैंने पहले भी कहा था, it is since 1951, तब से उनकी, मतलब basically ये तो दूसरा मामला है, मैं उस detail में जाना नहीं चाहूँगा, मगर ये basis वहाँ जो उस वक्त से पड़ी हैं और उस वजह से जो फिर regional conflicts पैदा हो गए, मतलब जम्मू एक तरफ सोचने लगा कश्मीर दूसरी तरफ, हालांकि कश्मीर का एंटी जम्मू था नहीं, कश्मीर का अगर कभी रहा एंटी इंडिया रहा, एंटी जम्मू कभी नहीं रहा, मगर जम्मू का एंटी कश्मीर रहा, ये बात है, उसे मतलब उस तरीके से पैदा किया गया। बराबर पूरी अच्छा, जो ये मतलब वहाँ माहौल इस नियत का रहा और उस माहौल को जिस तरीके से कैपिटलाइज किया गया इन हिंदुत्व कुवतों की तरफ से सारे मुल्क में, एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली आफ्टर 2014 जिस तरीके से इसको एक मतलब सपोर्ट मिला स्टेट का, मतलब स्टेट की तरफ से भी, अभी एक बात चल रही थी कि वहाँ रैली हो गई है हथियार लेकर, एक बात ये नहीं कह रहे हैं उसमें, हमारे उस वक्त के असेंबली का स्पीकर मतलब निकल लगाकर
आरएसएस की निकल लगा
पानी पिला रहा,
बिल्कुल
रियलिटी, और उस वजह से तब से आज तक देखिए, आज पोलराइजेशन हमारी स्टेट की, हिंदू जम्मू, बौद्ध लद्दाख एंड मुस्लिम कश्मीर, और फिर मुल्की सतह पर क्या कुछ हो रहा है। ये तो आरएसएस की जो पॉलिटिक्स है इसको फाइट किया जा सकता है सिर्फ पीपल्स यूनिटी, और वो भी उनके अपने इशूज़ को लेकर, जो अगर रीजनल इशूज़ भी है डेमोक्रेटिक है, उनको भी एड्रेस करने की बात है, एंड वी आर फॉर दैट।
लेट मी आस्क ए क्वेश्चन विच इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट राइट नाउ, द डिसएंचेंटमेंट ऑफ द यूथ इन कश्मीर, एज यू सेड एलियनेशन, जिसको हम एलियनेशन बोल रहे हैं, डू यू थिंक कट डाउन ऑफ पोलिटिकल एक्टिविटीज, बैनिंग ऑफ जमात in a Muslim majority state and not having a place to protest and dissent, don't you think it's going to further alienate?
See, I'll tell you 2-3 things. First, we were told that, you know, this is an economic problem because youngsters don't have jobs and they don't have money, so they take up arms. Now, when you had people like Rafi Bhatt or the people or those MBA passed out,
Mananwani,
and then people like Rafi Bhatt, who was a professor in the university.
Yes.
Now, this changed the whole narrative, what government of India made us to believe, that it is all about economic doldrums and occasional packages. This was proved all false. The fact is that Kashmir is a political issue. Unfortunately, the government of India never understood that. They never thought that, you know, let's reach out to the youngsters and talk to them what exactly is their problem. They were never made to believe that they have a right to dissent, they have a right to protest, they have a right to talk. I mean, let's agree, there have been stone pelting across the country. I'm not for once condoning that. But the fact is that there have been instances in the country, but you have never used such force against them. Pallets. I mean, where in the country have you seen 10,000, 15,000 young boys and girls being pallet victims? Where have you seen a young girl, a 6-year-old or 7-year-old Aisha, her eyes has lost? I mean, come on, you have to somehow or the other reach out to the youngsters, which unfortunately hasn't happened all these
years. I have a point to make, and I direct to Suhail Bukhari. You regional political parties, they talk about democracy. Do you think that democracy can coexist with Operation All Out? Mm-hmm. And since Operation All Out, I will just read out the figures to you. Under governance model of Narendra Modi, militancy related incidents increased by 176%. That is from 222 in 2014 to 614 in 2018, and that is happening under Operation All Out.
I think, you know, as my dear friend was referring to, the bottom line remains that Kashmir essentially is a political problem. The operation of security forces against armed militants and vice versa has been on for last 30 years. That has neither solved the problem for either of the parties. It has not helped the state to ensure that the issue is taken care of. It has not helped those who are seeking political resolution, who are seeking resolution of the problem through gun. It has not helped their cause either. We need to understand one very critical lesson from what has happened in the last 1.5 months. The Pulwama incident has taught us one very critical thing, that maybe we should now at least understand that the trigger for a nuclear war in whole of South Asia is probably lying in some youngster from Pulwama or any other part of the country. That had almost brought us to the brink.
इसमें मैं एक बात ऐड करना चाहूँगा, हाँ, जहाँ तक अभी देखिए ऑपरेशन अलाउड का जहाँ तक ताल्लुक है, देखिए ये दरअसल खासकर 2014 से ही ज़्यादा, पहले भी था इसमें लेकर, मगर फिर भी देर वाज अ डिफरेंस, मगर 2014 से जिस तरीके से ये कश्मीर के सवाल को, मतलब जैसे उन्होंने राइटली कहा कि इट्स अ पॉलिटिकल इशू, सियासी सवाल है, इसे एड्रेस करना है सियासी तौर पर, मगर ऐसा समझा नहीं गया, इसे मिलिट्री रिलेटेड इशू समझा गया, मतलब सिक्योरिटी रिलेटेड इशू समझा गया, और फिर सिर्फ आर्म्स भेजने हैं, सिर्फ सिपाही भेजने हैं, मिलिट्री भेजनी है।
45,000 ट्रूप्स हु वर सेंट ड्यूरिंग पंचायत पोल्स आर स्टिल प्रेजेंट हियर, एडिंग टू द एग्जिस्टिंग नंबर ऑफ ट्रूप्स दैट आर हियर इन कश्मीर।
दे आर बीइंग एडेड नाउ, और भी नए स्थल से और भी लोग लाए जा रहे हैं ना, पर ये मामला बनाया गया है डंडा यहाँ पिटने के लिए कश्मीरी पड़ा है, और जब तक ये सिलसिला चालू रहेगा देयर विल बी नो फ्यूचर फॉर डेमोक्रेसी इन आवर कश्मीर।
यू मेड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, अनलेस एंड अंटिल देयर आर पॉलिसीज और थिंग्स लाइक ऑपरेशन ऑल आउट, वी कैन नॉट से दैट देयर इज डेमोक्रेसी इन कश्मीर। टर्निंग टू पुलवामा अटैक दैट वी हैव बीन टॉकिंग, देयर आर टू डायमेंशंस टू पुलवामा अटैक, वन इज इंटरनल एंड अनदर इज एक्सटर्नल डायमेंशन। व्हाइल द एंटायर इंडिया वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट एक्सटर्नल डायमेंशन दैट वाज जैश-ए-मोहम्मद लिंक टू पाकिस्तान, वी ऑल मिस्ड द, वी वर सो बिजी इन टॉकिंग अबाउट एक्सटर्नल, वी ऑल मिस्ड द इंटरनल डायमेंशन टू इट। The internal dimension was a 19-year-old boy hailing from Pulwama, weaponizing himself, that, and that is happening after 15 years, which happened in 2000 in Badami Baga.
I'll come to the point. I know where are you going with this, but the fact is that this is what we've been crying ever since this BJP government came into being in Delhi. All the advances that the successive government had done, reached out to the youngsters. There was very less radicalization then, but suddenly the trigger where youngsters would take up arms. I mean, for once, I don't agree it's a great step when the army chief or anybody from Delhi establishment says that we killed 300 militants.
Yes.
The fact that why did those 300 young boys become militants, that is the core point of it. Why did they were not militants a few years back? They suddenly became militants. What happened?
Seen the stories of everybody who is becoming a militant, even if for that matter, Adil Ahmed Dar, that 19-year-old boy.
Imagine a young boy becoming a militant. I'll not go that far. I'll go about this assistant professor. He became a militant on Thursday. Friday, he was a militant. Saturday, he went to a place. Sunday,
he was killed.
Within 3 days, he was killed. Look at the lifespan of these militants. They're not well-trained, but the ideology, the mindset that has become, we need to reach out to that.
To Suhail Bukhari, don't you think that demilitarization is the first thing which should be done in Kashmir?
Demilitarization has been one of the core points of agenda of PDP particularly. Whether it be the self-rule document itself or for that matter the agenda of alliance, which was the written commitment between BJP and PDP, it very categorically talked about the fact that there has to be demilitarization in the areas wherever there is gradual improvement in the security scenario. You cannot straight away order, for example, let's be very practical about things. If you are talking about areas like Pulwama and Kulgam, where there are militants present, nobody can actually ask the security forces to withdraw immediately.
Troops have been increased in last 5 years.
If the situation is not right, of course there will be more security presence.
I want Ghulam Nabi Malik to make a quick point on this. Demilitarization in Kashmir.
Jahan tak jo maine isse pehle bhi kaha ki yahan jamhuri mahol qayam karne ke liye bandook ko piche karna padega. Kis tarike se, kahan se shuru hoga,
kaise bandook, militant ki bandook ya security force ki bandook?
Abhi is waqt jab hum baat karte hain state ki bhi responsibility banti hai, kyunki they are responsible and answerable. Pehle unko to shuru karna hai, aur jahan tak militancy ka, we are not for militancy, matlab jis tarike se wo bandook utha rahe, aur abhi aap sun rahe the professor, matlab ye aaj ladka gaya aur mara, वो मरने का रास्ता है, वो जीने का रास्ता नहीं, हम उनके लिए भी जीने का ही रास्ता चाहते हैं, और दोनों के लिए जीने के लिए सिर्फ एक ही रास्ता है, दैट इज़ पॉलिटिकल प्रोसेस, डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस, और वो बंदूक से हासिल नहीं होगा, वो वहाँ से भी छोड़ना होगा, यहाँ से भी छोड़ना होगा।
देखिए इसको, आई विल जस्ट ऐड टू दिस, अब आप कहते हैं हमें बार बार कि यहाँ डीमिलिटराइजेशन हो, यहाँ मिलिटेंट्स क्यों बनते हैं, यंगस्टर्स क्यों भटके हुए हैं, पर उसके साथ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ये नहीं समझती है कि जब यहाँ हम डेमोक्रेसी की बात करते हैं तो जूँ ही जम्मू कश्मीर की बात करते हैं तो डेमोक्रेसी कहीं नहीं है। आप गवर्नर को यहाँ रखते हैं जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट्स करते हैं, ही हैज़ नो मॉरल राइट टू डू दैट, वाई वुड ही डू समथिंग, आई मीन ही टेल्स हिमसेल्फ दैट ही इज़ द चीफ मिनिस्टर, ही इज़ नॉट, फॉर ही इज़ अ नॉमिनेटेड पर्सन बाय द प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया। it is the elected government, whether it is from
you
the any
the
political party.
They have not only encroached,
they have done so much damage to the democratic structure in Jammu and Kashmir that that's why people are getting dissatisfied here.
मतलब जितने भी स्टेट्स हैं हमारे मुल्क की हर स्टेट में हालांकि वहाँ 370 नहीं है मगर वहाँ की सरकारें अथॉरिटी हैं वो जो कुछ चाहते हैं करते हैं मगर यहाँ 370 होने के बावजूद यहाँ की असेंबली को कभी वो अख्तियार नहीं दिए गए जो उनका राइट बनता था इवन इस हद तक कि 1996 के बाद जो असेंबली बनी उसमें वो रेजोल्यूशन 98 रेजोल्यूशन पास हुआ और किसी ने देखा भी नहीं उसकी तरफ असेंबली का यूनानिमसली था उसमें बीजेपी वाले लोग भी थे सभी ने यूनानिमसली पास किया था किसी ने देखा भी नहीं उसकी तरफ और उसके बाद अभी जो एजेंडा ऑफ अलायंस हालांकि पहले पता नहीं वो इनको भी वाकफियत है या नहीं क्या था वो क्या नहीं कहने को था मगर कहाँ गया सिर्फ ये कहते रहे बीजेपी के क्यों और यही गवर्नर का मामला है गवर्नर यहाँ वायसराय से भी ज़्यादा बड़ा है ये यहाँ जो दिल्ली वाले चाहते हैं दैट इज बींग इम्प्लीमेंटेड हियर यहाँ के डेमोक्रेटिक इंस्टीट्यूशन नहीं यहाँ मतलब ना बिल्कुल ना मतलब जो अख्तियार हैं इंस्टीट्यूशन के हर लेवल पर उनको तो मतलब डिसरेस्पेक्ट किया गया
देखिए
देखिए बुखारी टू यू अगेन दैट एनक्रोचिंग द पॉलिटिकल स्पेस ऑफ द रीजनल पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज व्हाट यू वांट टू से अबाउट दैट
देखिए मसला किसी रीजनल पार्टी की स्पेस को एनक्रोच करने का नहीं है क्योंकि ये स्पेस किसकी है ये ना आप डिसाइड करेंगी ना नेशनल पार्टी डिसाइड करेंगी ना रीजनल पार्टी डिसाइड करेंगी जब इलेक्शंस होंगे क्या पता किसी नेशनल पार्टी को ज़्यादा मैंडेट मिले या ये हो सकता है किसी रीजनल पार्टी को ज़्यादा मैंडेट मिले तो स्पेस किसकी है उसकी बात नहीं करते लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल स्ट्रक्चर लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर दैट आर सपोज टू बी इन प्लेस एंड टू बी एग्जीक्यूटेड in the way that constitution had provided for them. That is where there has been an onslaught recently. Dekhiye, inhone kaha ki agenda of alliance, hum sab ko pata hai that RSS aur BJP ka ye ekdam sworn agenda hai ki jo special status hai Jammu and Kashmir ka, usko khatam karna hai. Article 370 ko abolish karna hai. Jab agenda of alliance bana, ek written commitment li gayi ki aap Article 370 ke baare mein baat bhi nahi karenge, status quo maintain hoga. Aur jab tak sarkar rahi, tab tak unhone ऑन रिकॉर्ड इस पर कुछ नहीं कहा और जैसे ही ये सरकार गिरी एक वे उनको लगा कि एक मौका मिल गया है तो जो दिल्ली के डिज़ाइंस थे जम्मू कश्मीर के स्पेशल स्टेटस को हर्ट करने के उन्होंने नॉमिनेटेड गवर्नर के थ्रू वो सब करना शुरू कर दिया मेरे दोस्त ने पहले ही जिक्र किया कि किस तरह से एक नॉमिनेटेड गवर्नर रिप्रेजेंट करता है स्टेट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द स्टेट विच इज सपोज टू बी अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव पॉपुलर गवर्नमेंट व्हेन इट कम्स टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मैटर्स कि कहाँ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट्स होनी है तो उसी एजेंडे को हम तो कहते हैं कि सिनिस्टर डिज़ाइन है कि आप गवर्नर रूल को कंटिन्यू कीजिए दिल्ली और RSS के जो एजेंडा है उनको अनहिंडर्ड इम्प्लीमेंट करने की कोशिश कीजिए और जो रीजनल पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज हैं जो पॉपुलर गवर्नमेंट्स हैं उनको इस रास्ते में ना आने दीजिए यही वजह रही कि साइमल्टेनियस इलेक्शन नहीं हुए बावजूद इसके कि सारी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज ने कहा था कि कीजिए हमको बताया गया कि सिक्योरिटी इश्यूज हैं रिइंफोर्समेंट का मसला है फिर हमने पूछा कि ये बताइए भाई साहब कि आपने तो पंचायत और UBL इलेक्शन कराए उसकी रिक्वायरमेंट तो फार मोर थी जब उस वक्त कोई परेशानी नहीं थी तो आज क्या परेशानी हो रही है
तनवीर सादिक डू यू आल्सो सी दिस not holding simultaneous assembly election as a sinister design by the GOI?
Of course, we have been saying this from the day one. We were the ones who sent the letter to the election commission that you have no reasons because under Supreme Court law, you have to have election within 6 months. And then there are people who say, ki nahi, simultaneous election kaise hoga? Please understand, in the past, because Jammu and Kashmir has 6 years, jo tenure hota hai, jo duration hota hai, and parliament is 5 years. So, of course, wo kabhi simultaneous nahi hota. But because this was the first time that it had come together, they had security forces, they had everything with them. But because there was a sinister design, because they had a nominated governor who is trying, who is hell-bent to somehow weaken the constitution of Jammu and Kashmir, these 3 years, three important things happen. And I am sorry, I'm not putting fingers. GST happened, that was economic onslaught on our autonomy. Then food security bill happened. And the third biggest mistake that the PDP president did was when she resigned as the chief minister. I wish she had written that I hereby seek dissolution of the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. Because if that had happened,
Suhail Bukhari,
you would not have had a governor here doing an onslaught on the constitution.
Suhail Bukhari wants to make a point. After that, Ghulam Nabi, you will join in.
Both the friends are like mature politicians. They have an eye on the history of the state. So I don't think it would even be required for me to say what happened to the special status of the state, who brazenly trampled upon it, who literally sold it off for power of generations. It's very important to understand that when there is a central law, it is for the state legislature to decide whether to implement it or not, and that would be decided on what kind of good or bad it brings to the state. These are not the first laws that have been brought into or extended into the state based on the ratification of the state legislature. We have had certain laws being ratified and brought extended earlier also. Now tell me, for God's sake, if there is a Food Security Act which helps a commoner, a poor person, to get food security at nominal rates.
How does it help?
Of course it helps.
Of course
it's for
it
the
doesn't.
People of the state. You want them to starve and...
it doesn't. We had our own act.
Let's talk.
We had our own act. And the last question he didn't answer. The resignation of Mehbooba Mufti and not seeking dissolution of the Assembly.
I think that it's absolutely clear that even when the two political parties at the regional level wanted to come forward, come together and form the government, we saw governor behaving the way he did.
That's
so when it comes to what happens to the Assembly, that has been...
No. You know constitution very well, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Gulam, make a quick point. Yes,
ma'am. Sirf dekhiye, inki sarkari rahi hai, hum, matlab, isse bahir rahe hain. Magar, matlab, aaj tak kya hua hai, history batati hai. Magar ek baat main zarur kehna chahunga isme ki yahan ki koi bhi sarkar jo rahi hai markazi sarkar ne use agar usne chaha bhi kabhi waise chaha kafi kam magar jab bhi chaha use matlab aage lene ka mauka diya nahi markazi sarkar ne ye raha hai ye jo alienation ka mamla hai jis tarike se aaj ke halaat mein jo policies aaj tak in 5 barson mein ikhtiyar ki gayi even wo log jo really militancy ke sath nahi the वो भी पुश किए गए उसी की तरफ एक डिवीज़न हुआ हमारी कॉमनल डिवीज़न हुआ हमारी स्टेट का जैसे आप अभी आप कह रहे थे रेडिकलाइजेशन ये सवाल भी सामने आ गया और फिर जिस तरीके से मतलब ऐसा लगा सारा मुल्क बिलमुकाबले कश्मीर खड़ा हुआ तभी जाकर बंगाल में भी यूपी में भी और हर किसी जगह पीटा गया मारा गया व्यापारियों को हमारे बच्चों को अब डर ऐसा लग रहा है कि मतलब मुझे खुद भी लग रहा है मैं ट्रेन में सफर नहीं कर रहा हूँ
मुझे भी ये डर लग रहा है हर किसी को
ट्रेन में सफर नहीं
सारे कश्मीरी को डर लग रहा है
द रिएक्शन ऑफ कश्मीर वर्सेस इंडिया बिकेम टू ब्लंट आफ्टर पुलवामा अटैक द काइंड ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइज्ड हैरेसमेंट ऑफ कश्मीरी स्टूडेंट्स एंड ट्रेडर्स एज वेल द काइंड ऑफ हैरेसमेंट दे फेस एक्सपोज द नॉर्मलाइजेशन ऑफ द सेंटीमेंट ऑफ वांटिंग कश्मीर एंड नॉट वांटिंग कश्मीरीज
द रीसेंट डेवलपमेंट्स हैव ब्रॉट इट टू फोर that how the moment they are out of the alliance in Jammu and Kashmir, we saw how Kashmiris were hounded, not only in the region of Jammu, but also through length and breadth of the country. And the worst part of it was that no less than a constitutional authority like a governor of a state had utterances suggesting that there should be boycott of Kashmiris. And until the Supreme Court of the country intervened, we did not see the Prime Minister utter a single word.
मतलब खुशी महसूस होती है उस वक्त जब वो लोग जैसे यहाँ लखनऊ में हुआ लखनऊ में वो डंडा लेकर पीट रहे थे उन बच्चों को मगर कुछ लोग वहाँ खड़ी भी हो गए और वहाँ हमारे अडवा के लोग हमारे DYF के लोग वो आ गए मतलब वहाँ अडवा का हमारा कन्वेंशन था कॉन्फ्रेंस थी उन्होंने इन्वाइट किया यहाँ के ट्रेडर्स को और वहाँ वो मतलब खुलवाए उनके दुकान और ऐसे लोग भी हैं उनको
आई मीन दैट इज़ द पॉइंट आई थिंक इस वक्त जो सबसे बड़ा डिवीजन हमें पता चला दैट वाज विद दिस इंसिडेंट द हिंदुत्व दोज फोर्सेज वर गिवन फ्री हैंड आई मीन लाइक आई सेड इट्स ऑल अबाउट इलेक्टोरल पॉलिटिक्स द मोर यू बीट कश्मीरीज द मोर यू सम हाउ हैरस कश्मीरीज इट ट्रांसलेट्स इनटू वोट फॉर हिंदुत्व ग्रुप्स बट हैविंग दैट बीन सेड व्हेन यू सेड the Prime Minister of India, when we say he's not a Prime Minister of the BJP, unfortunately he proved himself to be the Prime Minister of the BJP and not the country, he should have stood up and said, look here, the Kashmiris are a part of us. It's not only about the land, it's about the people living there.
In New Zealand.
I mean, look at how the Prime Minister came out and hugged the people. I mean, this is the leadership quality.
And the statement she made that this is not New Zealand.
And this is us. I mean, it's an attack on us. I wish the Prime Minister had said this on the very first day. I don't think Kashmiris would have been harassed. But another very important thing is that there are people, like my friend just now said, especially the Sikh people from Sikh community, who opened up, who welcomed Kashmiris everywhere. And this is, I mean, and the retaliation here was, or the response from the people of Kashmir was, that all the hotels were opened up, the dhabas were opened up, restaurants were opened and welcomed Sikh community people and people from Hindu community who helped them. I mean, there are good people across the country. Unfortunately, is waqt time galat hai. Prime Minister jo tha, wo galat tha. Jo party thi, wo galat thi. But we have a hope that things will improve from here.
Wants to make a quick point.
Yeah, I only wanted to, you know, add to what already has been said by Tanveer, is that it's, you know, created this division. I wouldn't say it has created, it's just brought it to the fore in the limelight, and it already existed.
It's more dominant.
Exactly. And the most worrying part of it all, see, RSS has always been there. Their anti-Muslim stance has been there. But what has been special this time around is that it seemed to have an outright
support
from the state. And as Tanveer mentioned, I'll also second that thought, that this has a lot to do with the electoral politics, because Narendra Modi-led government was cornered on issues of corruption, on issues of development, on issues of economy. They had nothing to show to the public. And therefore, all that, this facade was created. The more you beat a Kashmiri, the stronger your chances of electoral victory in the mainland India.
My last question to all of you, that Article 370 has triggered anxieties in Kashmir among the people who think that if the Article 370 is abolished, what will happen to the state? How as political parties you are thinking to protect it? Assembly elections are not there. There is no chief minister currently. The state is under president's rule. I want you to talk about that.
It has been a full-fledged plan, conspiracy cooked up in Delhi by people in RSS and in Nagpur. This has been all along their program. But what is important is that if you do that, you open the whole instrument of accession thing. Are my friends in the BJP ready to daily open that book again? Because if you open that, you are essentially opening the accession of Jammu and Kashmir towards Delhi. If you're ready for that, by all means. I mean, then let's have a referendum. There'll be nobody there left to take the flag of the country. I mean, there are people, like I said, we mainstream political parties have been here telling the people, look here, we are better here. Things will pass. There'll be better tomorrow. Because the country as in itself is a good country. Some people do not reflect the sentiment of the people of the country. Of course, that has got a huge dent with what has happened in the last 4 or 5 years. But we are trying our best. But if you fiddle with the special status of Jammu and Kashmir, you are straight away, you know, you are playing with fire.
You won't have
anybody here.
Look, where the 370 was, as Tanveer Sahib said, he is right in saying this, that 370 was, मतलब कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनली कोई हटा नहीं सकता क्योंकि ऐसी कोई गुंजाइश है नहीं, मगर यहाँ इनसिक्योरिटी मतलब वो फीलिंग बढ़ाने के लिए, ताकि यहाँ के लोग ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा मतलब दे आर बीइंग पुश्ड टू वार, ये कोशिश है यहाँ पर। मगर दूसरी बात, इसमें एक और बात जो मैं कहना चाहता हूँ कि इस चीज़ को लेकर ये RSS, BJP और हिंदुत्व कुवतें सारे मुल्क को मरवाना चाहते हैं। ये उनको पीटने के लिए एक यहाँ एक्सपेरिमेंट किया जा रहा है। हम कश्मीरी लड़ रहे हैं, लड़ेंगे, और जम्मू कश्मीर के लिए लड़ेंगे, ऐसी बात नहीं।
कोई गलत नहीं
है।
आई जस्ट वांट टू यू नो, इट्स ऑलरेडी बीन सेड दैट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनली नॉट पॉसिबल, वी वुड फाइट इट टू टर्न नेल टू यू नो, इट वुड बी ओवर आवर डेड बॉडीज। बट वन सिंपल सेंटेंस दैट आई डू वांट टू पुट ऑन रिकॉर्ड इज दैट नो आर्टिकल 370, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर सीजेस टू बी पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया। दैट्स इट।
Very important point you made, Suhail. I want to ask you, in Jammu, Dogras and Kashmiri Pandits have come together and have found natural affinity towards BJP. How you see that, Kashmiri Pandits?
I do not have data available to me to, you know, make a conclusion like the one that you are drawing. But when it comes to politics and electoral politics, we are in a democracy. Individuals, communities are free to choose the parties or the individuals that they want to. I would not hold it against anybody if they want to associate or affiliate with BJP.
3 decades of long battle. Do you see any end to it?
See, we've had, I would not say only 3 decades. I would rather want to, you know, put it on record, and all of us know that it dates back even further. We've had miserable times. All of us have been affected directly or indirectly. We've lost people, we've lost, you know, our happiness, we've lost honor in all these decades. But having said that, because we are Kashmiris, we just cannot afford to be hopeless. We have to be.
Then Mir Sadiq, you want to make a point on that?
I think you know, I agree to what Suhail is saying. You know, normally across the world, if you have an incident of a gunfire somewhere, the whole community in the neighborhood is taken for counseling. And then they are, you know, somehow brought together, and then there are people who counsel them. Unfortunately, people are in depression. I mean, let's agree to the fact that there are lots of people who have lost their loved ones. People who have, I mean, I've read it in a report that the highest rate of depression is in the Kashmir Valley, and that's obvious because so much has happened. But I believe that there is a lot of hope. And if you don't have hope, I think that is the day the Kashmiriyat will die. Kashmiriyat is hope. And I believe the day is not far when all of us together will be talking here and in peaceful atmosphere, and things will become back to normal.
Ghulam Nabi, you want to make a point decades of long battle. Do you see any end to it?
Yes, sir. Of course. Jahan tak, matlab dekhiye, halanki hamara Kashmir, sara gaon kabristan se bhara hai. Matlab isi period mein, jo log mere kabristan bhare hain aur shaheed mazar unke naam rakhe bhi gaye hain. Ye hain. ये मतलब एग्जिस्ट कर रहे हैं, मगर इसके बावजूद जो लोग यहाँ इन तमाम बातों को मतलब इनके इस एक्सपीरियंस को लेकर जो वो चाहते भी हैं, मतलब वो चाहत जो उनकी है ज़िंदा रहने की, और वो रिवायत जो लाल आज़ाद की और शेख नूरुद्दीन नूरानी की हमारे साथ है, वो हमें आगे बढ़ने में मदद ज़रूर देंगे और वो है हमारे साथ, वो विरासत उसे हम आगे लेने वाले हैं और हर कोई कश्मीर उसके साथ चलने के लिए तैयार है भी आज भी.
Thanks for joining us.